Over 2,000 years ago, ancient Chinese scholars observed the changing patterns in our natural world, the climate, the turning of the seasons, and astronomy. The scholars measured and divided the sun's annual movements into 24 equal parts, creating the 24 solar terms, which were used to govern agriculture in ancient China. Even to this day, this invention still guides the lives and traditions of hundreds of millions of Chinese people. Around the 8th of September each year, the Chinese people welcome the 15th solar term, White Dew. Temperatures begin to cool and migratory birds set off on their southward journeys. It's time for savoring the autumn scenery, and for those far from their families, reminiscing memories of home. As mid-autumn approaches, the weather turns cool. At the early hours of dawn, if you look closely enough, you can see dewdrops on foliage start to crystallize. This is the 15th term of the 24 solar terms. The Chinese people have named it White Dew. Guangxi, Guilin, located in southern China, with its remarkable karst landforms, is home to several Chinese ethnic minorities. This peculiar natural environment, combined with a diverse array of cultures, has made everything about this place seem extraordinary. The days leading up to White Dew are known as the Ghost Festival, and a grand ceremony is about to commence. Human societies hold family, relatives, and ancestors close at heart. In many places around the globe, people believe that those who have left this world continue to live on in another. Every year, during the Ghost Festival, the people of Guilin perform a floating river lantern ceremony in which the deceased are remembered whilst the living are blessed.
师父您是现在在干嘛呢？我在这里把这个龙角，这只龙的角装上去，这么一个那么长的龙，它还能顺着漂到那儿去了吗？这个呢，把它放到河里面，它因为它这个扎了这个浮，那个能够浮起来的，它的这个架子，它能够从河里面水上可以飘下去。Feng
Wenxun is a local farmer. Every year during White Dew, he receives a new identity, river lantern craftsman. His family have been making river lanterns for over 160 years. These river lanterns are the highlights of the Ghost Festival ritual. Not far from the riverbanks, over a paddy field, lies Feng Wenxun's makeshift workshop.
像这个叶子都是带金黄色了，带金黄色的这个稻谷也带金黄色了，嗯，但它是比较成熟，比较饱满。嗯，在我们这里有一句话就叫做“白露就白茫茫”，嗯，白露白茫茫，它就是这个就全都成熟了。你看起来一片金黄色了。你家在哪一边？
我家就在这里，就是这个房子，就是我的家啊。一直从小就在这长大的。
哦，我从小就是这里土生土养的。是吧？对。
这算是你的工作室，对，是我的工作室。这个应该是这个原材料是吧？
啊，对。
这竹子呢？我们这个河灯基本上都是用竹子扎的。我看这个粘的这边都是在长这个竹子是吧？哦，这个好看。
这个是，
也是你自己弄的。啊，
这个我弄的小白兔。嗯。哎，
所以其实灯有好几种呢，是吧？
很多很多的。
因为最近。 我还去过杭州，然后看了很多荷花，我看的这个就是像荷花的样子，是吧？
哦，对。
Truth be told, these river lanterns are not particularly elegant, but yet they have soul and they are truly beautiful. From bamboo designs to paper pasting and colouring, every step requires meticulous handling. The slightest mistake could easily turn a tiger into a kitten. During the white dew slack farming season every year, this handicraft work has given Fang Wenxun an extra portion of income.
插上这个蜡烛，点上火，许个愿，慢慢的把它放到河里面，放到河里面，也可以这样的慢慢的飘下去。
Night falls and the ghost festival ceremony begins. The glowing lanterns, set carefully onto the water, sail downstream. Hopes of a lasting river current carry the prayers and memories of loved ones far and beyond. Such a scene has repeated itself for thousands of years. Entrusted with hopes and promises, the lanterns float onwards, and as they depart from our sight, the harvest season of crops beckons, marking the beginning of the busy farming season. The summer holidays are also reaching their end. Young people gather their baggage and leave home, some to study, others for work. After coming to Guilin, I learnt of a Chinese saying, "The mountains and waters of Guilin are the finest of all." The mountains refer to these jagged lava forms. The waters point to the Lijiang River, which locals call the Mother River. Thousands of years ago, the people here began training cormorant birds to fish for a living. The bamboo raft sits on the magnificent river, human and bird working together, living by fishing. The white dew solar term each year happens to be when newborn cormorant chicks are growing, and is also when river fish fatten for winter hibernation. The perfect season for fishing has arrived.
<音>会咬人吗？不一定，比我想象的还大一点。我没想到这鸟这么大。那么大呀？我挺想跟它拥抱。哦，拥抱可以啊。<笑>但我害怕。不怕。因为在这里不怕的。你是从小就养它吗？还是你买来的？
这只是从小。
那奶奶是毛还没有齐的。嗯，就是自己养。买的时候就这么下。嗯，自己养的。啊。你怎么来选一个鸟？
反正你看它的长相帅不帅啊？嗯。嗯，眼睛、嘴，嗯，各方面那个脚，嗯，这个脚都要配合。
是吧？
嗯。
它能活大概多少年？120年。这种鸟。 它下蛋的话，就是每次就一个还是两个？
一个。
一个。
嗯。
它一般是什么时候的？一般。几月份的生？下蛋的。
2月份到4月份。
2月份到4月份。
嗯。
那它得，你得养它几个月，它才能到这种可以哺乳的这个样子呢？
一般有120天可以了。
120天。
啊，120天会教它。
4个月。
4个月。
4个月，所以正好到。
这个节气。
哦，对对对，
白露这个节气。
白露，
白露。嗯。To be honest, manipulating birds to catch fish can seem cruel. Fishermen tie thin hemp string around the bird's neck to prevent them from swallowing fish. Huang Chonggui is 73 years old. He started fishing with his father, age 17. Today, he is the most well-known successor of the art of cormorant fishing.
Come on, boys, get in there. Oh, he's gone right underneath us.
Not bad. Look at that. Beautiful.
Go get another one. Go on. Get in there.
Come on, guys. Get some more. Can you catch me a fish?
Most fishermen of Huang Chonggui's generation have spent their lives living on boats. Their entire world is built upon what these birds can provide. In their eyes, cormorants are their closest companions. Yet, in this ever-changing age, the relationship between fishermen and cormorants are no longer that simple. Due to the demands of tourist industry and under the local government's administration, fishermen like Huang Chonggui have long since moved out of their boats and settled in the residential area by the riverbanks. Here, they are still able to continue their fishing habits. 那你周围都是朋友吧？
啊，这里都是我们的渔民，都是姓黄的。
都跟你一个姓？
啊，都是姓黄的。
是吗？
都是家人。
去你家看看吧。
好的。
就你家，
哎，对，
你好，你好，你好，你好，
哎，进来坐坐坐坐坐，吃点水果啊，
这
你好，你好，
你好，哦，你好，你好，
坐坐坐坐坐坐坐，你吃一点我们这当地的水果吧，
好，
这个季节才有的是最好水蜜桃，
这不是桃吗？
桃呀，桃，桃有很多种的，
是吧？
哎，
这个跟季节有关的，
对对对对，
好吃，
对，
非常好吃，
好吃就多吃点，
嗯嗯嗯，黄金菜。Is Huang Chonggui's second cousin. From his mannerisms and attire, I feel that he is already worlds apart from the lifestyles of traditional fishermen.
这个村子里现在还有人养就是这个鸬鹚鸟吗？
有啊，
多吗？
也不太多了。
你有是吧？
我有啊。
你有？你有几个？
我现在一个。
你有几个呢？
我有九个。
九个？
对。
啊，养的也很累。
前辈老人传给一句话，我们称他们称的叫什么？叫养命仔。
什么意思？
就他养活我们的，他是我们的养命的儿子。
嗯。
地方语言就养命仔。
养命仔。
也就跟儿子那种感觉。
嗯。
所以我们很尊重他。
嗯。
Raising the cormorants is not an easy undertaking. Other than feeding them, you have to train and care for them day after day.I was surprised that Huang Jingcai had 9 chicks. I don't believe that his relationship with the birds is solely bound together by affection. With its unique stunning landscapes and ancient fishing culture, Guilin has long since become one of China's most famous tourist attractions, and the locals no longer rely on cormorant fishing as a means of a living. Using Guilin's mountains and rivers as the stage, the live show Song of Liu Xianjie, directed by China's famous film director Zhang Yimou, is a major tourist attraction in Guangxi province. Within some 800 performers, over 200 are fishermen from the surrounding poorer villages. It is said that the performances increase their annual income by at least 20 to 30,000 yuan. Fishermen by day, actors by night. This has already become the lifestyle of the local fishermen. In this performance, Huang Jingcai is responsible for organizing the village fishermen.
90%。There's
no better stage than the moonlit Lijiang River. Performance preparations are running smoothly. Huang Jingcai is managing backstage. His nine cormorants, the unmissable lead actors of every performance, have taken already their positions under the audience gaze. Hiring cormorants for performances is clearly much easier than fishing in terms of making a living. For thousands of years, lush mountains and rivers reside here. The women sing the most beautiful folk songs, whilst the men catch the most delicious river fish. The cycles of time have turned, and life seems as if unchanged. Many people miss the old Lijiang lifestyle. That was a simpler world when money was not so important. Yet, we must recognize that times are changing. Some traditions are inevitably fading away, whilst others, under our persistent efforts, endeavor to remain in their original forms. The White Jew solar term is about to pass. The ghost festival ceremonies are also coming to an end. During this period, the Chinese people look back on times past and send their most prosperous wishes for the days to come.